There's a lot of action at Lawrence University. Different things for different people. But more important, Lawrence has quiet times for study, for thought, for reflection. Generations of young people have come to study at Lawrence, not to learn how to make a living, but rather to learn how to live. This has been happening for a good many years, 125 years. Quality teaching, meeting the needs of students, and meeting the challenges of an increasingly more complicated life. Challenges bring changes. Sometimes changes aren't fast enough for Lawrence students. Sometimes changes seem to come too fast for parents and alumni. But change comes constantly, thoughtfully. In the midst of change, basic values are retained. The college continues to maintain its position of leadership and its quality. With its diverse student body of 1,400, it is still a small liberal arts college where students can know other students well and members of the faculty. It's exciting to get to know other people and begin to find out some of what they know. The excitement of learning is important at Lawrence, the finding out of new things. Some of this is expressed by Thomas Hedrick, Vice President for Academic Affairs.
In many ways, a lot of the things that students will learn today aren't going to be worthwhile knowing in 10 years from now. The knowledge will have that they hold today will be obsolete in 10 years. So having learned their job well, what they've learned is how to learn. And the hope is that they'll continue learning, that their curiosity will carry them forward, that their sense of pride in mastering something will force them to keep moving. That's one of the things we're trying to instill. And that's why, in a sense, philosophy and biology, political science and art, they all touch on the same kinds of concepts. In a more general sense, I guess what we're after is what someone once said in a rather lovely way, we're trying to make people's minds interesting places in which to live for the rest of their lives. And that's it. It is an academic experience. It's of the mind. It's learning to, as we've said, think critically, probe below the surface, solve problems in different sorts of ways.
To achieve this, there are 23 departments at Lawrence, offering more than 400 courses and covering a wide range of subject matter in the major academic disciplines. In the humanities, the student examines past knowledge, which leads to an understanding of man's thoughts, beliefs, and actions. In the departments of classics, philosophy, foreign language, history, religion, and English, as with others, a student is able to improve the quality, widen the scope, and increase the intensity of his own intellectual activity. One area continuing growth is education. both elementary and secondary. In student teaching, they meet the community face to face and often provide a service to children by offering one-to-one tutoring when needed. An important part of student teaching is the chance it gives students to reacquaint themselves with children and young people and to try to teach what they know. Science, too, has shown new leadership. The strength of the science departments is in their outstanding faculty and facilities. The natural and social sciences come alive at Lauren in a variety of ways, offering a wide range of courses in biology, chemistry, physics, mathematics, geology, anthropology, psychology, sociology, economics, and government. Lawrence science departments are better equipped than those in most small schools. And the sophisticated equipment is for use by students. Through special grants frequently awarded the university, Lawrence students have the opportunity to pursue research normally encountered only at the graduate level. Students work on individual projects, projects related to their own interests. Here is a chance to devise, test, conclude. Independent work is done under faculty guidance. Whether a student is a science major or a history major who wants to know something more about science, Lawrence provides an essential foundation, an introduction to the science of man. Work done in both the classroom and independent study is of highest quality. Teachers and students share the excitement. Again, the personal relationships between student and teacher is closer and less formal. But sometimes, the classrooms share time with football and other fall sports. Intercollegiate athletics have been a part of Lawrence tradition for 75 years. The Vikings have always been more than respectable in the Midwest Conference and have had their share of titles through the years. Student athletes receive no special compensation for participating in Lawrence sports. Bringing physical fitness and mental alertness to play in a game is their only reward. Another fall sport has been added to the roster of activities, soccer. It is fast, rough, tough, and the excellent team has already built up an enthusiastic following. Lawrence alumni traditionally return to the campus in the fall. It is the time for informal reunions, picnics, and getting acquainted with what's new. It is at this time, too, that alumni think back and remember their own life at Lawrence, the reasons they loved it, the reasons so many encourage others to attend. Marjorie Harkins Buchanan, a trustee and alumna of the university, put it this way.
It was the teacher. And any good teacher could make any subject interesting and exciting. And as I thought about it and remembered my own years at Lawrence, and since what I remember most about Lawrence were the people with whom I worked. And I think this is what a small liberal arts college can do that no big university can do. And Lawrence is able to do exactly that for its students and is still doing it. The contact with a professor who's excited about what he has to teach, who's interested in the student, who cares about what he's doing, this is what Lawrence has to offer that no other school I know does.
Yes, people are what make Lawrence, the people and the way they relate. Contacts are not as formal today as they were several years ago. Proms, corsages, dinner dates, all a thing of the past. But the relationships may be more significant, and each student has the opportunity to have true friendships. Men and women at Lawrence consider themselves and are considered to be adults. With this maturity comes responsibilities. The addition of students to committees previously restricted to faculty members has brought undergraduate representation to almost every level of university government. The Lawrence University Community Council is composed of students, teachers, and administrators. It is an important and unique group, working in all non-academic areas within the university. It affects the atmosphere in which the Lawrence community works and plays. And for the Lawrence student, winter provides an appropriate playground. The Appleton Chamber of Commerce states that the average annual snowfall in Appleton is 47 inches, and they are usually right. Always in winter, though, the library remains the most popular center for research, for study, for quiet talk. There is a lot of learning here, and most of the students enjoy doing it. Lawrence's book collection was significantly supplemented when Milwaukee Downer College merged with Lawrence in 1964. Library holdings consist of about 190,000 volumes, 110,000 government documents, 75,000 microform items, and more than 800 subscriptions to periodicals and newspapers. Students may also use the university's computers to analyze data in their research. The campus ice rink gets a good workout all winter long. The games may be informal, but all the enthusiasm and fun are there. Students enjoy more structured games at Alexander Gymnasium. It provides for the physical education of the students, a wide range of activities, including 9 varsity and 5 intercollegiate club sports. Use of the gym continues to grow. Basketball, swimming, handball, fencing, badminton. Only 1 year of physical education is required, but many students spend hours in intramurals and other informal recreation. It is used both night and day. Communication and publications are important to many students. In addition to the weekly student newspaper, radio has become a regular part of Lawrence life, providing campus news and music to suit everyone. The art department does not look to produce artists. The visual arts offerings are designed to give students experience in both the studio and historical fields of art, joining one's own creative spirit with feeling and understanding. Intelligence, coupled imagination, works through a variety of materials and processes to evolve visual imagery. The Lawrence Theater provides additional cultural opportunities for students and the Appleton community. Through an understanding of the theaters, past and present, a student becomes acquainted with the life, thought, and dramatic literature of all times.
That's all right, my roommate's gone now too.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
At the same time, the Department of Theater and Drama does not neglect techniques. For the proof of a student's work in theater is his ability to communicate his knowledge and inspiration to an audience. In cooperation with the physical education department, courses in dance, either modern or ballet, and stage movement are available for both men and women. The largest number of students in history have enrolled in the university's Conservatory of Music recently. Its national reputation, the combination of liberal arts and conservatory, brings students here from all over the country. Music is for everyone at Lawrence, both majors and those who enjoy it as an extracurricular activity. There is something for all. Music courses have been expanded to serve the general student, and jazz has become recognized as an important dimension of music. Many are studying jazz with aspiration to a professional career. The conservatory educates teachers for the public school system. More students now are preparing for concert or opera, membership in a symphony orchestra, or college and university teaching. All good beginnings for the continual progress to graduate school. The campus boundaries have been expanded to a great deal of work outside Appleton. No student needs to feel trapped in northern Wisconsin. Many take full advantage of off-campus study opportunities, urban studies, the Argonne Science Program, summer geology trips, and of course, study abroad. Lawrence staffs two overseas study centers, one in Germany and the other in London. There are many thrills in foreign study. The Tower of London or Westminster Hall are fascinating to read about. To see them is exciting, stimulating, unforgettable. Why be satisfied with a picture of the Haymarket Theater? Sir Alex Guinness is playing there. Buy a ticket. Go in. Look around. To your right, that's the Royal Box. When the doors of the British Museum open, whole new worlds are there to be seen. Getting around, talking to people, participating, being a part of one of the great world capitals. This is what it's all about. The Lawrence student gets to know Europe in different ways than most Americans. He's not here on vacation or on a tour. He's here to dig deep into the city, the towns, the country, to learn from older scholars how to excavate ideas, to see things with new eyes, with new attitudes. Because the group is small, students and teachers create more intimate learning experiences. Each week, after 4 days of concentrated classes, the walls of the classroom are replaced by the boundaries of any European country. two terms of foreign study means learning a foreign culture as it really is. It cultivates a willingness to understand the otherness of others, from which grows a deeper understanding of oneself.
Um 8 Uhr, gut. Frau, Herr Weber fliegt 9 Stunden. Ja? Um wie viel Uhr fliegt er? Um 9 Uhr, gut. Ne? Und das geht so weiter, vielleicht noch einen. Hier, Frau Hartmann fliegt eine Stunde. Sie fliegt um 17 Uhr, gut. Nun, wir können das gleich überspringen und gehen weiter dann.
Nein.
Unser. Sie meinen jetzt der Hertz, ja? Hier und jetzt?
Vielleicht etwas zur politischen Seite. Wir sind hier eine
Professors are here to suggest, to guide, to pinpoint, to emphasize, to urge, to stimulate. But Europe has become the classroom. Back on the campus, signs of spring have returned to Appleton with all of the activities that lead to the completion of a school year. Both work and play are a little more concentrated, and plans are being discussed for studies the following year. Special programming is investigated. Students may cross departmental lines to pursue interdisciplinary majors, may design their own course, or enroll in a unique new program, the Scholar of the University. To be a scholar of the university, a student need not have exceptional grades. More important is the desire and ability to formulate an educational program acceptable to the university and within an area of faculty competence. The student design plan of study may include regular courses, off-campus programs, tutorials, or independent reading and study. The faculty, 85% of whom hold doctoral degrees, concerns itself with maintaining rigorous standards while meeting the special academic needs of individual students. Possible because Lawrence has a student-to-faculty ratio of 11-1. And then, graduation, most students will receive Bachelor of Arts degrees, while the rest will receive their degrees in music. All reach the point, not an end, but a beginning in the world where whatever they do will depend largely upon their own resources. For more than 125 years, Lawrence has helped young people go on to positions of responsibility and leadership. Lawrence was chartered on January 15, 1847, by the Territorial Legislature of Wisconsin. Amos Adams Lawrence, a Boston merchant, offered $10,000 and a plot of land to the Methodist Church for the Institute of Higher Learning. The school flourished. The Conservatory of Music became a separate part of Lawrence in 1885, although music had been in the curriculum from its earliest days. In 1929, the Institute of Paper Chemistry was founded by a group of Wisconsin Pulp and Paper Company executives, and degrees were granted to the graduates through Lawrence. Consolidation of Lawrence and Milwaukee Downer was announced on October 22, 1963, and all of the educational resources were moved to Appleton. Lawrence once again became known as a university, preserving the rich cultural heritage of Milwaukee Downer in its Downer College for Women and forming the Lawrence College for Men. University President Thomas S. Smith.
Lawrence University is built on the efforts of many, many men and women over a century and a quarter. This deep dedication, which we have inherited in an excellent university, is something that we all should cherish, recognize, and build upon. It seems to me that the future of the university really depends upon that concept, that we recognize the efforts that have been made by others and make similar or greater efforts ourselves. That the next 100 years depends upon that idea. Here we are, a relatively small liberal arts college and conservatory of music with a reputation behind us that is strong, particularly in these days of decreasing respect for higher education. And I'm firmly convinced that Lawrence is going to continue to be a leader in the future because of people who care, people who have cared and people who are caring now. This will sustain us and make us even greater as the years go by. But it's going to take the effort of a lot of people, people who have been here and people who are here, the future students, the past students. Presidents will come and go, and Lawrence University will continue as a center of learning, a place where people are not concentrating on how to make a living, but really concentrating on how to live. Our whole effort, I think, is to understand the relations between people, man to man, man to institution, men to governments, and how they function and why they must continue to function, why we must always strive to improve those relationships. This is Lawrence. This is what it means.